Hi students, today we will do the revision of question 3b short question answers of unit 3 and 4 and 5. So let's start the revision. And these are the question answers of poem 3 run. Number 1, what does the poem tell us to do? Means the poem run, what tell us to do? Answer, the poem tells us to run throughout the day away from the city towards the countryside. The poem tells us that run throughout the day and away from the city and towards the countryside. So, at these places we have to run throughout the day. Number 2, write about the places where the poet wants us to run. Here we have to mention the places that indicated in the poem. The poet wants us to run towards the countryside, under the trees, down the hillside, up the street, through the meadow. These are the places that the poet tells us to run. First, towards the countryside, under the trees, down the hillside, up the street and through the meadow. So, these two question answers of poem 3, and now we go for chapter number 3. And these are the question answers of chapter number 3. Number 1, why did Nasiruddin take someone else's name each time he missed the target? Answer, Nasiruddin did so to defend himself. He didn't want to show his failure in his skill in archery. So he took someone else's name each time he missed the target. This question tells that why did Nasiruddin take someone else's name when he missed his target? So Nasiruddin didn't want to show his failure in his skill in archery, so he took someone else's name. Number 2, why did Nasiruddin say it was my aim the third time? Answer, he was lucky in his third attempt. He successfully hit the target, so he said it was my aim. Number 3, do you think Nasiruddin was good at archery? Answer, I don't think Nasiruddin was good at archery. He only boasted about it before his friends. So, these are question answers of unit chapter number 3. And now we go for unit 4. And these are the question answers of poem number 4. Number 1, name a few things that sink. Here we have to mention the names of things that sink. Answer, pin, lead, marble, stone, spoon, etc. There are many things that sink, but we have to write here only some names. Number 2, list 3 questions that the little boy asks. Here we have to mention 3 questions asked by boy in the poem. Answer, why we eat and drink, why the flowers die, and why sun should sign. So here I mentioned 3 questions only. You have to mention another question from the poem. And here are the question answers of chapter number 4. Number 1, while listening to the story, what did Alice see? Answer, while listening to the story, Alice saw a white rabbit running hurriedly. What Alice saw that white rabbit running hurriedly around her? While listening to the story. Number 2, what was different about the rabbit that Alice saw? The rabbit that Alice saw was different as it could talk. The first thing is that it could talk and also wore a red waistcoat and carried a watch. These 3 things are different that the rabbit that Alice saw. And now we go for the next. Number 3 is, where did the rabbit go? Answer, the rabbit went into the rabbit hole. And number 4 is, how did Alice reach Wonderland? Answer, Alice jumped into the rabbit hole following the rabbit and reached the Wonderland. Alice followed the white rabbit and he reached Wonderland by jumping in the hole. So, these are the question answers of chapter number 4. Now we go for unit 5. And here is poem 5. Number 1, what is the poem about? Answer, the poem is about how to not get afraid of the darkness. The main subject of the poem poem is that how to not get afraid of the darkness. Number two, what does the poet want us to do? Answer, the poet wants us to be friendly with night and think about our friends and relatives. So in this poem, the poet says that be friendly with night and think about our friends and relatives at night time. And now we go for the third. Number three is, what happens when the day is over? Answer, when the day is over, darkness spreads everywhere. The moon and stars start shining in the sky. We all know that what happens when the day is over. So these are question answers of the poem. And now we go for chapter number 5. And here are the question answers of chapter 5. That number 1, something is wrong, sighed Helen's mother. What was wrong with Helen? Answer, Helen became blind and deaf due to her illness. She could not see or hear. This wrong thing happened to Helen, that she became blind and deaf due to her illness and she could not see or hear. Number 2, although Helen could not hear or see, what kind of girl was she? Answer, although Helen could not hear or see, she was a bright little girl. She was very, very bright girl, though she could not hear or see. Now we go for the third. Number 3 is, how did Miss Sullivan help Helen? Miss Sullivan was a name of teacher of Helen. Answer, Miss Sullivan taught Helen many words with the help of special hand signs. She made her understand the importance of words. Miss Sullivan helped Helen by special hand signs, and she made her understand the importance of words. Number 4, what did Helen learn when the teacher put her hand into running water? Answer, Helen understood that water meant something wet running over her hand. When her teacher put her hand into running water, Helen understood that water meant something wet, liquid, that running over her hand. So these are the question answers of unit 3, 4 and 5. You have to remember all the question answers very well. Thank you.